If we want to change the location of a point, we can use a translation matrix. This matrix has the translation movement put in the top three positions of the last column. The rest of the matrix looks the same as the identity matrix. If you multiply a point by this matrix, the one coordinate in the last position of the vector multiplies each translation value in turn. This has the effect of taking the original point and adding the translation to it. This may seem like a convoluted way to add a vector to a point, but you'll soon see that many other transforms can be combined and stored in this matrix, translations among them. With a single matrix multiply, you can then perform any number of transformations. Say instead you multiply a vector by this matrix. You'll get the same vector back. The fourth coordinate of the vector is 0. So for all the translation values, they're multiplied by 0 and so ignored. This makes sense. A vector does not have a location and so cannot be translated. One thing worth mentioning at this point is that this type of matrix and vector notation is called column major form. There is also a row major form for notation, where the coordinates are written out in a row. The vector row is multiplied by each column of the matrix in turn. Personally, this is how I learned matrices 30 years ago. Microsoft's DirectX uses this form. The story I heard as to why row vectors became popular was due to the influence of Steve Koons. He wrote some influential papers on transformations for computer graphics back in the 1960s. He said he used row vectors in those papers because it was easier for the stenographers to type the translation values along the bottom of the matrix rather than having to type them in the column. All that said, WebGL uses column major notation, and this convention is also the norm in most publications, so that's what we'll use here. Either form is fine. They're both just a way of writing down the math. I mostly want you to be aware that there's another form out there called row major. The good news is that, internally, WebGL and DirectX ultimately store the translation values in the same locations in memory. If you go look at any matrix in memory, you'll see that the last four values are the three translation values and then a one.